فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. صبر مر كم اسمك؟ نعم مر. إن شاء الله تعالى the topic that I was told to speak about that I was told to speak about is the relationship of the Qur'an, about the relationship of the Sunnah to the Qur'an. Okay, the topic that I was told to speak about is the relationship of the Sunnah to the Qur'an. And when I was given that topic, I was very excited, and I think it's a very important topic. So inshallah ta'ala, the heading and the title which I have chosen to give it is خُطُورَةُ مَنْ يَتَأَوَّلُ الْقُرْآنَ بِجَهْلٍ عَنِ السُّنَّةِ. The danger, so I'm going to speak about it in two points بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ. The first one inshallah ta'ala is going to be the dangers that it holds when a person comments on the Qur'an whilst they are ignorant of the Sunnah. You don't know the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you comment on the Qur'an, the dangers that it has. Al-Imam ibn Abd al-Barr rahimahullah, he has a great book called Jami' Bayan al-Ilm wa Fadli. And this is the book where students of knowledge read. What they take from this book is the importance of knowledge and the virtues of knowledge. So it's a book for a student of knowledge. A person who wants to embark on the path of knowledge, this is the kind of book he would read. And one of the etiquettes that a student of knowledge is told to come with, he will state it in that book. In this book, he said something very powerful. He says, أهل البدع أجمعوا أضربوا عن السنة وتأولوا الكتاب على غير ما بينت السنة فضلوا وأضلوا ونعوذ بالله من الخذلان ونسأله التوفيق والعصمة برحمته. وقد روي عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم التحذير عن ذلك في غير ما أتى منها. He said that the people who have gone against the path of the Messenger, the deviated people, the misguided people, the innovators. What he did was, he said, أَضْرَبُوا عَلِ السُّنَّةِ. All of them, they went against the Sunnah. In what? وَتَأَوَّلُوا الْقُرْآنَ, and they commented on the Qur'an عَلَى غَيْرِ مَا بَيَّنَتِ السُّنَّةِ. They commented on the Qur'an in a way which the Sunnah didn't mention. In other words, they gave meaning to the Qur'an, which if you try to look for a sunnah to prove it, you won't find it. فَضَلُّوا وَأَضَلُّوا. So they became misguided and they misguided other people. And then he goes on to say, وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. We seek refuge from Allah. مِنَ الْخُذْلَانِ. That Allah humiliates us and Allah destroys us. وَنَسْأَلُهُ. And we ask Allah sincerely, التَّوْفِيقَ وَالْعِصْمَةِ. That Allah gives us the ability of coming with good, and that Allah makes us free from errors and mistakes with His mercy. وَقَدْ رُوِيَ. He said, and it was also narrated. And so Ibn Abd al-Barr, what he does is he brings his chain of narration from himself, from his teacher, to his teacher, to his teacher. So his teacher was Abdullah ibn Muhammad, up to the companion of the Messenger. His name is Uqbah ibn Amir al-Juhani. So he's trying to connect his understanding. Look, Ibn Abd al-Barr is trying to say, this is what the innovators do. Now he wants to bring a hadith for it. But remember, at that time, no one would narrate a hadith unless he brought it from himself to the Prophet. So he brings a chain from himself directly to the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. And this is what the Messenger said. He said, هلاك أمتي في الكتاب واللبن. That the Messenger said, the destruction of my people is in two things. Pay attention to this. My people, my ummah are destroyed because of two things. What is it? الكتاب واللبن. The kitab. And اللبن, milk. So the companions, they said, Ya Rasulullah, ما الكتاب واللبن? What is the kitab and what is the لبن? What is the kitab that you're talking about? And what's this milk that you're talking about? The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he responded by saying, يتعلمون القرآن, they learn the Quran. ويتأولونه على غير ما أنزله الله عز وجل. They learn the Quran. بمعنى من ناحية اللفظ. In terms of its wording, they learn it. يقيمون حروفا. ويتأولونه, and they comment on the Quran على غير ما أنزله الله عز وجل. But then when they come to commenting on it, their commenting of the Quran is away from the Sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. ويحبون اللبن, and they love milk. فيدعون الجماعات, so they leave of the congregation, they don't come to the masjid. والجمع, they don't come to Salat al-Eid and when the people come together. So what do? ويبدون. ما معنى ويبدون? ويبدون means they go to the Bedouin lifestyle. That's why Arabs used to find milk, fresh milk. So they'll go out of the city and they'll go to those places. So now we learn two things that our people are destroyed with. The Qur'an, when it is explained and it is commented on other than that which a messenger meant. And exactly, wallahi, that is the manifestation that we just saw taking place in London, the bombings and things that were happening, were people who were taking in the Qur'an, and you ask them, what's this that you're using? Ayah min kitabillah, verse from the Qur'an. But where was the commenting coming from? From himself. From who? This is the path of every single person who has become misguided. The reason why they're misguided, if you follow it up, you will find that it is what? يَتَأَوَّلُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. They comment on the Qur'an بِجَهْلٍ عَنِ السُّنَّةِ, whilst they are ignorant of the Sunnah. Now there's another statement, Umar رضي الله عنه. عبد البر شفيت من كتاب جامع بيان العلم وفضله. He brings another statement of who? Umar رضي الله عنه. You know who Umar is, right? Umar رضي الله عنه, look what he said. He said, إِنَّمَا أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ رَجُلَيْنِ. I fear two types of people for you. Two types of people is who I fear for you. Umar is saying this. First one is, رَجُلٌ يَتَأَوَّلُ الْقُرْآنَ. A person who comments on the Qur'an عَلَى غَيْرِ تَأْوِيلِهِ. He comments on the Qur'an in the way that he shouldn't have commented on the Qur'an. He gives the Qur'an meaning that if you looked at in the Qutb al-Tafasir, you bring Tafsir ibn Jarir al-Tabari, Tafsir ibn Abi Hatim, Tafsir al-Baghawi, Tafsir ibn Kathir. Other than that, if you open any books of Tafsir, you will never find that which he said in it. So that's the first type of people I fear for you. The second one is, وَرَجُلٌ أَيْمَانٌ يَتَنَافَسُ الْمُنْكَ عَلَىٰ أَخِيهِ. The second one is, a person who is competing with his brother in leadership. In other words, elections and stuff like that. Competing with somebody in leadership, that's what it is. Those are the two paths, the two things that Umar رضي الله عنه is saying, I fear for you. Have we seen all of them? نعم. We've seen them. That's the reality in front of us today. And it's not fair that everybody points their finger at somebody else. It's really good to look at ourselves as well. When we take an ayah from the Quran, that we ask ourselves, لذلك أئمة السلف, they used to say, I think Abbas and other were narrated from them. He said, قد أسمع فائدة. I sometimes may hear a فائدة, but I أكتب, I don't write it. Until I find with this فائدة two testimonies, two witnesses, الكتاب والسنة. I hear somebody say something very beneficial. I want to write it down. I wish to write it down, but I'm not going to write it down unless there comes with it two witnesses. What are the two witnesses? الكتاب والسنة. The next fa'idah, inshallah, the next comment is, the next statement comes from Ibn Abd al-Barr. Sorry, Ibn Abd al-Hadi. Now, Ibn Abd al-Barr used to be referred to as Imam Ahl al-Maghrib. And at his time, there were two Imams that divided the world into two. One was known as Imam Ahl al-Maghrib, who was Ibn Abd al-Barr. And also the opposite one was Ahl al-Mashriq, was who? Does anyone know? Al-Imam Al-Khatib Al-Baghdadi rahimahullah, both of them were at that time, they both held their sides of the world. There's also another Imam whose statement I'm going to read on you. His name is Ibn Abdul Hadi. Ibn Abdul Hadi, he is a contemporary of Ibn Kathir. It was Ibn Kathir's best friend. And he was a student of Al-Imam Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. And he is the man, he died at the age of 38. Billahi alaykum. He wrote a book called As-Salim al-Mumki fi al-Raddi ala al-Subki. Ibn Abdul Hadi died at the age of what? 38 only. Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi is the author who wrote the kitab Tahdhib al-Kamal fi asma'i a'immat al-kutub al-rijal, the six books of hadith. Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi said, when Ibn Abdul Hadi used to enter onto me, he used to come to my house sometimes and visit me, he said, لَمْ أَسْمَعْ مِنْهُ شَيْءٍ, I never had anything from him إِلَّا وَاسْتَفَدْتُ مِنْهُ, except I benefited from him. Do you guys know who Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi is? Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi is somebody who Ibn Taymiyyah used to read on him sometimes. Ibn Taymiyyah would bring up our hadith and he would read it on Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi. Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi is saying to Ibn Abdul Hadi, a young boy, that whenever he would come to me and I would sit with him, I would benefit from him. And the reason why I'm mentioning you this is because when I read the statement, you know the weight of who said it. So a lot of the times when we say this Imam said it, people don't know the value and the weight of the person who said it. Ibn Abdul Hadi rahimahullah, he said, وَلَا يَجُوزُ إِحْدَاثُ تَعْوِيلٍ فِي آيَةٍ. It is not permissible to initiate a commentary on a verse. You're not allowed to make it up. Listen. أو فِي سُنَّةٍ or a hadith. Unless what? لَمْ يَكُنْ عَلَىٰ أَحْدِ السَّلَفِ. This commentary was not at the time of the Salaf. وَلَا عَرَفُوهُ. And the Salaf didn't even know about it. وَلَا بَيَّنُوهُ لِلْأُمَّةِ. And the Salaf didn't clarify it in this particular way that you're clarifying it to the people. فَإِنَّ هَذَا يَتَضَمَّنُ. Because if you come to a verse and you read it and you say, oh people, this is what this verse means, then this means أَنَّهُمْ جَهِلُ الْحَقَّ, that the Sahaba and the Messenger were all ignorant about this haq that you've become guided to. يَتَضَمَّنُ أَنَّهُمْ جَهِلُ الْحَقَّ فِي هَذَا وَضَلُّ عَنْهُ وَاهْتَدَى إِلَيْهِ هَذَا الْمُعْتَرِضُ. And you have become guided to it. Rasulullah was jahil about it. Abu Bakr was jahil about it. Umar was jahil about it. Uthman, Ali, all of them, until you came and you got the understanding of the ayah like this. So it's very dangerous. The time is very restricted, inshaAllah ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and he commented on the Quran. And Allah tells us in the Quran, وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الذِّكْرَ لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. Muhammad, we sent down the Quran on you. And what was upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was what? To clarify the Quran. As the poet said, فَسُنَّةُ النَّبِيِّ وَحْيٌ ثَانٍ عَلَيْهِمَا قَدْ أُطْلِقَ الْوَحْيَانِ وَإِنَّمَا طَرِيقُهَا الرِّوَايَةِ فَافْتَقَرَ الرَّاوِيُّ إِلَى الدِّرَايَةِ. The Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam's job was to do two things. The first one was to teach the companions the wordings. Did he teach them how to read the Quran? As much as he taught them the wording, he taught them the meaning. You can't separate the two. He taught them how to read it, and there's many evidences that he used to teach them to read it, alayhi salatu wasalam. If you look at the companions, they would always say, the Prophet taught us istikhara the way he used to teach us that Quran. Why was the Quran the example here? It's because that's how much the Prophet used to teach us the Quran. Allah says, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُذِرِينَ بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍ مُبِينٍ. The Quran was always placed in the heart. So the Messenger made sure that it entered into their hearts. And they were huffab whilst the Prophet was alive. The second thing that the Prophet taught them was the meaning. Now some of you may say, okay, when the Prophet taught the meaning, did he teach the meaning by opening the Quran and saying, this is what this ayah means, and this is what this ayah means, and this is what this ayah means? No. No. Then when the Prophet ﷺ, he explained the Quran, he explained it through two ways. But there's a statement I want to read on you before I give you examples of the two statements. Al-Imam Shafi'i said in the Kitab al-Risala, this is a very powerful statement. He said, كُلُّ مَا حَكَّمَ بِهِ الرَّسُولِ. Every warning that the Messenger gave and he passed, فَهُوَ مِمَّا فَهِمَهُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. It is what he understood from the Quran. Every judgment that the Prophet passed, it is something he understood from the what? Why? When did he get that from? Because Allah says to the Prophet, أَنِتَّبِعْ Muhammad follow, إِنْ أَتَّبِعْ إِلَّا مَا يُحَى إِلَيَّ. I do not follow, the Prophet saying, except that which has been sent from on top of me. The Prophet saying, I don't follow except the Quran. Sahih? So the Prophet ﷺ, he explained the Quran to the companions. There's two ways he did it. The first one is that he sometimes explained a verse. He explained it verbally. He said, this is what this verse means. What did the Prophet ﷺ say? إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. What did the Prophet say غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين was? The Prophet said مغضوب عليهم is اليهود. الضالين is النصارى. That's تفسير قولي. The Prophet came and he commented on this verse. He said this is what he means. Are you with me, brothers? That's the first way. That's not very common. And he wasn't a mufassir in the sense where he would sit down and he'd comment every verse like that. He wasn't doing that to Ali. The second one is the most one, which is through his action. The 23 years of his life is a tafsir of the Quran. When Aisha was asked, she was said, what is the Prophet's etiquette and his manners? How was it like? What did she say? Kana khuluquhu? The Quran. His etiquette and the way he carried himself was the Quran. In other words, the Prophet was the manifestation of the implementation of the Quran. He was showing the people how to what? Implement the Quran. ولذلك, if you come to the ayah, for instance, أقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِدُلُوكِ الشَّمْسِ إِلَى غَسَقِ اللَّيْلِ وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. Or you come to the ayah, وَأَقِمُ الصَّلَاةَ, establish the prayer. Where would you find that? In the Prophet's action. He stood on the pulpit and what did he say to the people? صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِي. The man came to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم in his masjid, المسيء صلاته, the one who went bad in his prayer. And the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said he came into the masjid and he said السلام عليكم to the messenger. And the messenger said to him عليه الصلاة والسلام ارجع, go back, فصلي فإنك لم تصلي. Go back and pray, for verily you haven't prayed. And so the man kept going back and kept going back and kept going back until he came to the messenger and he said يا رسول الله, I cannot perfect it, this is all I can do. Then the messenger taught him how to pray. That prayer that the Prophet taught him how to pray is the tafsir of the Qawluhu Ta'ala وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. Establish the prayer. Are you with me, brothers? So the tafsir of the Qur'an is found in the Sunnah from the angle of the Prophet's speech عليه الصلاة والسلام, and it is also found in what? His actions. ولذلك a woman came to Aisha and she said يَا عَائِشَ يَا أُمِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, to the mother of the believers. إني أريد, I want to not have children. I want to be a person who never has children, and I want to leave children, and I don't want to get married. And Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها said to this woman in response to her, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. In the messenger is a good example. He's a role model for you. Follow him عليه الصلاة والسلام. And she said after that, قد تزوج رسول الله, the messenger got married and he married, وولد له, and a child was given birth for him. So don't get married, do what the Prophet did. So where did she get this ayah, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة? She used it for another action which the ayah wasn't specifically talking about, but because the ayah is very generic and comprehensive, she brought it back to this verse. Are you with me, brothers? So if you're going to comment on the Quran and you're going to explain the Quran, if you don't know the Sunnah, Ya Akhi Kareem, don't become the one who misguides himself and don't misguide others. Inna Allah la yantazi'u al-ilma intiza'an yantazi'uhu min sudur al-rijal, walakin yantazi'u al-ilma biqabdi al-ulama, hatta ila lam yubqi aliman, ittakhadha al-nas ru'usa juhala, fasu'ilu fa'aftaw bighayri ilmin, fadallu wa'adallu. Hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As al-Sahihain. Allah does not take knowledge like that. He takes knowledge by taking those who have knowledge of it. Allah takes those people of knowledge. What are the people who know, have knowledge? Ya ikhwati al-kiram, is those who know the Quran and they know the Sunnah. And the mission that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'm going to conclude with this, the mission that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, yeah? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the mission that he came to do was to educate the people with the Quran. لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُّبِينٍ. Also Allah says, هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. وصلى الله تبارك وتعالى said, ربنا وبعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة ويزكيهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. So my beloved brothers and sisters, the messenger came with two things, التزكية والعلم, to purify the people and to educate the people. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to what is right and what's correct, any mistake and any shortcoming that came from me whilst I was doing this talk is from me, and Shaytan and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. I ask Allah, He rewards each and every one of you for listening to your humble baby brother. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وجزاك الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.